A major development in our vaccine rollout this morning. Kids as young as 12 to be approved to receive the Pfizer vaccine.
And the Health Minister, Greg Hunt, joins us now. Minister, is this official then?
And good morning. Yes, so overnight the Therapeutic Goods Administration has approved Pfizer for kids 12 to 15. That's the first of two green lights that are required. The second is the Australian Technical Advisory Group on Immunisation. They're well advanced in their assessments already, and they are themselves likely to proceed in two stages. The decision is expected probably by the end of next week on immunocompromised or kids with underlying medical conditions, and if that's a green light, we'd immediately move to add them to what's known as the Phase 1B, the ability to get immediate access in line with everybody else that's immunocompromised or with an underlying medical condition. And then over the course of the period between now and mid to late August, they'll be assessing international data on 12 to 15 year olds, and we're quietly hopeful that that will be a positive decision for the whole of population, in which case we would then ensure that there's rollout during the course of 2021 through a combination of schools and general access.
OK, we'll talk timetables in a second, but just on the medical stuff behind this, we had Professor Peter Collignon on the show just 2 days ago saying that there just isn't enough data. Have a look at this.
Eventually we want to vaccinate children, but we need a lot more data. We need to make sure it is safe long-term for them.
And also, Professor Mary Louise McClaws was on our program earlier today. She suggested it could be a year before under-16s gets vaccinated. They're both right, aren't they?
Well, with great respect, the United States is currently vaccinating 12 to 15-year-olds, and we have followed the medical processes throughout. And so that's why, first step, Therapeutic Goods Administration, that's a green light. Second step, the Australian Technical Advisory Group on Immunisation. They're expected to make a consideration, and the indication from them is that they are positively disposed to the immunocompromised kids having early access. And then they're doing exactly what has been suggested, considering the international data over the course of the next 4 to 6 weeks. That's the approximate guidance it'll be for them. That's coming out of the United States on the safety and efficacy for kids. But right now, this vaccine is being used in the US for 12 to 15-year-olds. And so they'll make that careful consideration. And if it's a double green light, then we'll make sure that it's available. And those are the processes that have kept Australians safe, that have seen us have a loss of life that is just almost incomparably lower with the average around the developed world, let alone the developing world. And by doing that, we provide safety, efficacy and hope for Australians.
It's all well and good. It looks like a headline, but that's all it is at this point. We don't have enough for the rest of the population, as you know. I mean, it's been a complete schmozzle.
So let me step back. We've just had 184,000 vaccinations yesterday, easily a record. A million vaccinations over the course of the last 7 days. And so we're seeing, with the additional supplies that have come in, very significant vaccination numbers, people coming forward, over 10.6 million vaccinations. We purchased for whole of population coverage, and we've indicated that on many occasions, in case this were to come. So plan for those vaccinations if they were approved. Planning for delivery is already well underway. That's being led by Lieutenant General JJ Fruin. And right now, the really important thing is that Australians are coming forward in record numbers, as we were able to bring forward those earlier supplies of Pfizer, instead of 600,000 a week, being able to have a million a week at this point in time. All of those things are adding to the momentum, and we're seeing that acceleration, and we're seeing Australians step forward, and so that is really important.
OK, well, we do need to see that momentum and see it soon. Minister, thanks for your time this morning.
Thank you, Greg.
We always appreciate it.